justice for them.
From my understanding, old boy walked up with no shirt on first to check the scene, because he know what's going on in that parking lot. And had a conversation, probably seen nobody was in the doorways, checked Hustle had on shorts, checked everybody else, left. They say came back with a red shirt on. Tiptoed through the alley and went right and started shooting. So to me, that's premeditated. Number one, there's no red shirts in the hood. You can't buy no red shirt. No liquor store sell no red shirt. Number two, when a nigga come through the alley with a red shirt, that's the throw off, or the Bloods did it, or the Inglewood families did it, or the BPS, that's the throw off, red shirt. So for me, he felt he was supposed to do a job, or somebody sent him or whatever, and he was nervous. He was supposed to hit that alley with that red shirt immediately, but he didn't do that. He came in and he wanted to check the scene. He wanted to make sure he wasn't getting into a shootout.
Focus Connect back in the building.
I know Hustle.
And first of all, rest in peace to Nipsey Hussle. But what's going on in Cali with WAC 100, Loose Cannon, and Big U? Because it seemed like after the Black Sam interview on Big Boy TV, man, it brought out a lot. It opened up a scale. WAC 100 saying a lot of I told you so. I've been telling y'all this for months. I've been telling y'all this for years. After WAC 100 got exposed by Hassan Campbell, speaking up on the 30% that Big U was trying to get from Nipsey Hussle after his demise. But after WAC 100 was exposed, I got respect for WAC 100 about one thing in this situation. He stood on all 10 and he pressed the line the same way he talked. He pressed that line on Big U and he haven't let up since. So I can commend WAC 100 for that. Even though he do talk a little bit too much about street politics, policies, and I mean that as far as with the extortion, not even the Pyru stuff, the blood, whatever, the Crip, none of that. He speak a lot on crimes that done happened. When you talk about the extortion game, that is not legal. It don't take but one person to press charges for all this stuff to come up. They done spoke on even going back as far as when a gang was extorting Shaq for money, for protection. Then you got Loose Cannon speaking up. Loose Cannon saying a lot of different things he done for Big U. And we know Big U with the grid program, they calling Big U the police. Loose Cannon said he was giving serial numbers off of firearms at one time. And the plot just thickens when it comes to Big U and all the different things that he got his hands in. But you can tell Big U used to be in the bronze, not the brain. But when I see WAC 100 and Loose Cannon linking up with those two type of spirits together, if they together, they really, if they truly together, there's no telling what they might accomplish. But a lot of things that they confessing and saying that they know and they agreeing on, that they know that happened in these streets, you can't forget the feds watching. RICO charges don't just come from drugs. It don't just come from shootings. To get back to the point, Eric Holder knocked Nipsey Hussle off at the marathon store and saying that Black Sam said he came up there with no shirt on, left, came back with a red shirt on when he took Nipsey's life. And he's saying that they don't even sell red shirts in a neighborhood within a 60s neighborhood. You can't find a red shirt at a store, a gas station. Nobody selling red shirts. So Black Sam feel as if there was a decoy, so it wouldn't come back there with Chris. But I don't understand that if he just walked in there and these same people that's out here, they gonna recognize his face. So that kind of don't make sense. But when a family grieving, man, you never know how they gonna take certain things in, because you know it's a long history of Nipsey Hussle and Big U not seeing eye to eye on a lot of different situations. They saying Big U had a 10-year contract from 2009 to 2019 on Nipsey Hussle for publishing. And that's raising a lot of red flags to people, because Nipsey Hussle lost his life in 2020, a year after this contract was up. So that raised a lot of red flags after you think about the blemishes that's been put on Big U name as far as the streets go, as far as pressing these entertainers when they come to California. But I look at Eric Holder doing this shooting, if he was sent by Big U, would it really make sense for him not to snitch on Big U? If hours after the situation happened, they went to Eric Holder folks' house and people lost their life, shot his grandma's house up and people lost their life. Not no ride by, shoot the house up, no. People actually lost their life in this shooting that was there to Eric Holder. So at that point, do we really expect Eric Holder not to snitch on Big U if he was a part of it? Do you really think these people haven't investigated enough to check Big U phone logs or check his whereabouts within that time frame to dot all their I's and cross all their T's? Sometimes, man, you got to think a little deeper. But that's not to say that Big U wasn't happy Nipsey lost his life, because I don't know how Big U really felt about Nipsey Hussle, because a lot of things have came out to where we can see that they really didn't care for each other. Because Black Sam pretty much letting it kind of, he leaving you room to speculate, but he's standing on the fact that he think it was a well put together plan. And who else gonna prove for Nipsey Hussle to lose his life in the hood by a member other than Big U? And that's just understandable that from a family point of view, to look at it that way, when I know my brother had disagreements with this person in the past. I hope that Big U is not this type of OG. That Big U is not this type of general. And I don't see how Loose Cannon and Wack 100 trust each other when they the same type of beast. If I was Wack 100, I'd keep my third eye open on Loose Cannon. For the simple fact, if I know this was Big U soldier, if I know he the type of dude that Wack 100 saying he is as far as on the streets, because Wack 100 said he spoke up to Big U and said, hey, this little dude, here's something different. He ain't the type of dog, Wack 100 analogy he used, he said he not the type of dog that you walk. He the type of dog that's going to walk beside you. So within this, in that statement right there, I feel like Wack need to listen to what he's saying and take his own advice, because Wack 100 look like he in control, look like he pulling the strings, look like he trying to play that OG role. But who's to say that Loose Cannon ain't still playing by Big U beat? Who to say, oh, Big U ain't got Loose Cannon over there to get all the information, to get everything Wack 100 know? Get Wack 100 to trust him and let his guard down if they saying Big U this type of person. See, you got to go deep. When you accuse a person of being that type of person, where does it stop? So just because this guy presenting himself to Wack 100 as if he don't like Big U as well, or he got something against Big U, but these rolling 60s, you a Pyru. I just couldn't see myself trusting it on no end. I couldn't see myself trusting it on Loose Cannon end, or I couldn't see myself trusting it on Wack end. But one thing about it, we know that whenever it all play out, Wack 100 and Loose Cannon 9 times out of 10 gonna fall out, and a lot of things that they gonna expose about one another. But by these two guys being the type of guys that play chess the way they do, they probably got a trap set on each end. You might have Wack 100 with his receipts on things Loose Cannon said and did, and you might have Loose Cannon playing that same game with Wack. But man, this duo right here is dangerous. And like I said, man, with the situation, I wish the best for Nip family. I wish the best for Big U. I wish the best for all these guys. But man, when we look at the Black community side of this, man, as OGs, as people that's being looked up to, we gotta do better. Wake up, people.